Can ComfyUI run fast with AMD GPUs on Windows? Of course, there are options like DirectML and ONNX, but these are slow or cumbersome. ZLUDA is a better option. It allows applications to run amazingly fast on a subset of NVIDIA's CUDA API. A few days ago, I created a video about ZLUDA and sd.next, the fork of Automatic 1111. After receiving inquiries about ZLUDA with ComfyUI, I realized that this setup is quite easy to get. Nevertheless, it is an important requirement that you follow the mentioned video and install ZLUDA with sd.next. The link can be found in the description below. You also need to start sd.next at least once and generate an image at least once, so you can be sure that ZLUDA has already optimized the code and your installation works. Once this is done, running ComfyUI with ZLUDA is not far off. By the way, it would help me a lot to produce more content like this if you could consider subscribing to this channel. Thank you very much. Let's start with the installation.
We go to the directory where the subdirectory of sd.next is located. On my PC it is called Automatic because sd.next is a fork of Automatic 1111. At this location, we clone the Git repository of ComfyUI. We change into the newly created Comfy directory. In order to have ComfyUI run with ZLUDA, we need to modify two files of ComfyUI. The details are described in the pull request 2829 from Leek Rainey, a pioneer in ComfyUI with ZLUDA. Find the link to the pull request below. Now, this is important. As long as this pull request is open, follow the way described in this video. If it is closed, then most probably the changes have already been applied to ComfyUI and the following modifications are not required. But in this case, carefully read the comments of this pull request to be on the safer side. Click on Files Changed. The green lines of the README MD describe the modifications to be done. The first file to be changed is modelmanagement.py. The green lines have to be added, the red line has to be removed. Same has to be done with cuda-malloc.py. We start with modelmanagement.py. It can be found in the subdirectory comfy. We start an editor, for example Notepad++. Find the function getTalkDeviceName. We have to modify the try block below this function. So we copy and insert the green lines. It seems in the main branch the print command has been replaced by logging.info, so we update the lines accordingly. The top line, which is red in the pull request, has to be removed. Finally, we adjust the indentation according to Python syntax. Function blocks can be identified by their indentation. Incorrect indentation leads to errors. Same process with cuda-malloc.py. We open the file in Notepad++, find the function cuda-malloc-supported. And we insert the green lines and remove the red line where we pay attention to the indentation of the lines. We activate the virtual conda ZLUDA environment and we only have to call the main.py by using Python. Now I want to show you a common error and how to fix it. Instead of using spaces to indent in some places, I use tabs. this can be corrected very fast. Next try. Surprisingly, the quite important module Torch cannot be found. Checking the modules of the virtual environment results in a list of 3 basic modules. This is because when creating a virtual environment for sd.next, I had not considered that sd.next creates its own VNV virtual environment. But this can be fixed very fast too. In the sd.next directory, there is a VNV directory which contains a subdirectory scripts. Changing into this directory and calling the script activate, well, activates the required virtual environment. And yes, in the module list we can see a lot of modules including Torch. Nevertheless, in order to ease the usage for you, we use a different option. We deactivate the virtual environment and additionally we deactivate the conda environment. It's not required. Instead, we go back to the ComfyUI directory. Now we enter the path to the python.exe in the script directory from before. When this particular python.exe is invoked, it uses all the modules of the virtual environment it belongs to. For ease of use, you can create a PAT file containing this call to the python.exe main.py, then you don't have to type in this long line. Before starting ComfyUI, a small change is required. We don't want to have our stable diffusion checkpoints at 2 different places. So we will tell ComfyUI to use these models from the sd.next or automatic 1111 directory structure. Simply create a copy of the extra model path yaml example and remove the ending .example. Edit the file and comment the first line of the automatic section containing the base path. This is the place where you put your own base path. Make sure to have the slashes set correctly. By mixing slashes with backslashes, I had some trouble at that point. Now we can start ComfyUI. The very first start might take a while. The whole thing is still experimental and there are some error messages, however. They do not seem to have any influence on image generation. Important. In the command line output, there is a hint to ZLUDA and your GPU. If you do not see this line, double check the mentioned modifications. And again, the prerequisite is that sd.next has already been successfully started with ZLUDA, including the generation of the images. By the way, similar to a subscription, a like or a comment would help me continue with this type of content, so don't hesitate. We open the URL in our browser. What you can see here is the basic workflow I have taken from Cubic's ComfyUI workflow, the link is below. In the section Basic, there is a basic sd1.x workflow. This is the one I have downloaded. As you can see, the DreamShaper 8 SD checkpoint has directly been taken from the sd.next subdirectory, so we can use it. Set seed to 0 and start the generation. Similar to sd.next with ZLUDA, the very first generation takes some minutes, but not as long as for sd.next. Still, there is no corresponding output in the command window, so please be patient. As I did the first run before creating this video, you can only see some additional seconds following a restart of the ComfyUI. UI. 4.65 seconds is not too bad. What do you think?